chimbilaco, vuela chimbilaco, vuela chimbilaco, vuela chimbilaco, vuela chimbilaco, vuela chimbilaco.
Hi, I'm Vivian Hao, an environmental health scientist from University of Travel Asia. I'm happy to be part of Terra Metra 2020, Our Food, Our Planet, Our Future. My research interest is on environmental health and particularly on agricultural health. Therefore, I'm excited to be given the opportunity to share with you some pieces of my work, particularly on the role of chemicals and pesticides in the current agriculture and the consequences on human health. A pesticide is any substances that we use to kill, repel, or control certain forms of plant or animal's life that are considered to be pests. And all of this thanks to the Green Revolution, where it's introduced the chemical input in a large scale. Conventional farming focuses on intensive single crop production with the intention to unlock population growth and push the hunger down to the historical low. However, the use of synthetic chemicals on industrial agricultural farming, trying to maximize the use, has unknowingly leaving the negative impact on both the human health and environmental condition. Let me share with you on what we have found in our 5-year pesticide and human health studies. Since 2013, our team has worked on agricultural health study focusing on environmental, occupational and genetic factors on the health of farmers and the farm family, explore the potential link between the agricultural exposure and also the chronic diseases. And this is what we found. Number one, farm workers perform hand labor tasks in pesticide-treated area have increased their exposure to direct spraying, avian drift or contact with the pesticide residue in the crop and soil via skin and inhalation. Number two, these environmental residue have cross-contaminated farm children and affecting their chronic neurobehaviors and learning ability. Number three, the risk of renal toxicity has been found to cause the farm children's cell to experience early cell damage that lead to uncontrolled cell proliferations during their adulthood and carry the health consequences for the lifetime. Since pesticide could bioaccumulate in the human body, number four that we found is that pesticide residue was found in the urine of children who live near to these pesticide-treated farmland. And apart from contaminating human health, number five, this agricultural contaminant including pesticide, nitrate, and phosphorus impact the ground and surface water quality affecting both the urban and rural community. And lastly, our work also found that heavy metal as the impurities that soil received from the agricultural practice would bioaccumulate in the fish from the body trench. And fish is the main source of protein intake for the farming villages. Now, regardless if you are the farmers, the farming communities or consumer, the decade after the Green Revolution are now known as a kind of golden age of synthetic chemicals, where the earth is ushered in the widespread use of the pesticide and chemicals. And we, you and me, are not exempted from exposing to pesticide from our food to water and soil and in our environment. Whether all the stuff end up getting turned into the consumer food or burned or buried, it's never disappeared. It has to end up somewhere, and it does. It ends up in us. Here is the problem. Some of the pesticides that are used in our food crop production have been around for only a few decades. In other words, the human immune system has had only a few decades to adjust to most synthetic chemicals, many of which are chemically similar to the substances produced naturally by our own body. Some of these synthetic chemicals will interface with our hormone, some will attach to the chromosome, some will cripple the immune system, some will overstimulate certain enzymes. If we could easily metabolize them into the binary compounds and excrete them, there would be less of a worry. But unfortunately, many will accumulate. Therefore, it is not exaggerated to say that the effect of pesticide is doubling back. They are similar enough to react with us, but different enough not to go away easily once they are inside our body and reside in our environment. The more I began to look into this, the clearer it became that we have spent our life visually marinating these toxic chemicals in the food that we consume, in the water that comes from our tank, in the chemical we spray our wig, and so on. In fact, we know that the health effects don't just accumulate, they mushroom. In the past, scientists have shown that synthetic pesticide causes both the acute and chronic health effect. Now the scientists are beginning to worry and realize that the total of a person's exposure to all the little amount of the combined synthetic chemicals in the environment may cause more harm together than they do alone. At this point, you might be asking yourself, are we still hopeful? Is there any changes or solution needed in agricultural practice for a healthy planet and human that we could count on? This is critical as we are living in an era where rising income, globalization, and urbanization are driving dietary transition in which diets are shifting in a way that have substantial consequences for both the nutritional value and environmental health. And these diets that we mentioned are mostly prepared through industrialized farming system. While we are paying the cost of environmental damage and the price of the healthcare that is required to treat the accumulated pesticide in our food crop, the ultimate solution might lies in the sustainable agricultural system. So sustainable agriculture is a way of farming that favors the technique that emulate nature to preserve soil fertility, prevent water pollution, and protect the biodiversity. Of course, sustainable agriculture is more labor intensive, where rolling up your sleeve and dirt your hand for the nature is a way of living. It is not dependent on industrial food supply from the store. It is taught to cultivate your own garden, support agroecology or nature farming, and support local market. If we want to ensure that the planet maintains its ability to support us, we must start to considering the weight of how we farm our food. For years, our work provided the evidence-based agricultural health study that proved that one should not farm with a synthetic chemical just to feed the nations. There is always an alternative we could count on. In this case, sustainable healthy agricultural practice where we should not rely on the farmers alone, but using a more holistic ecosystem approach to sustainably serve the healthy food on our table. This is definitely doable, and we are counting on you.